Hey everyone, welcome back to The Dish. It wouldn't be the new year without some new projects from this guy. It is time for Trending with Signature Mike. How you doing?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. Can you believe it? 2020.
We're here, I know. We're done with the teens.
Sounds crazy. I know later on in life, people are going to be talking about the 20s. And
I know. It was like, yeah, I remember the flapper 20s.
When yeah.
I grew up, you know, but
what is it going to be known as now? Well, we'll see. Mike's probably going to have a lot to do with that.
Leaving the old, coming into the new. I'm going to take something new today and make it look old.
I love it.
I had a project that I posted that I did for a client that I posted on social media, and it went viral.
Yes.
People went crazy about it, and they wanted to know how to do it.
So I saw it, and I texted you almost right away.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, we got to do that on the show.
Yeah, so here's your chance, and you're going to see it's so easy. So
yes.
We're going to make antique mirror today.
Ooh,
and it's so easy. I take distilled vinegar and water. I do like 50-50,
okay.
And I put it in a spray bottle. I mean, it's as simple as that. You have a piece of glass cut.
Okay.
Just clear glass, and that's all you need. And we're just going to spray this liberally here.
So water and vinegar.
Water and vinegar, that's it. For more mirrored effect, you might put a little more, but that's pretty much all we'll do there. We take mirror spray. Uh-oh, I've got to get the lid
there
off.
You
here
go.
We go. This smells just a little bit. While it's still wet, you want to spray this, and you want to make sure you get the edges really good. My can's a little empty, so I have to hold it sideways here.
So while it's still wet, so that it creates that antique look.
It oxidizes
look.
with that vinegar and water. And you'll see how it's beating up there and all of that. So
what you want.
Yeah, there we go. You could add a little
more
if you, the more you add, the more reflection you're going to have. I love an antique mirror because it reflects light and reflects things, but it's not a clear mirror.
Right.
You know, and it looks old and aged.
Whew. Yes, I know, right? You might want to do this outdoors. We are inside right now, but it goes away pretty fast.
It does, it does. So let's say this is drying. I have one that I've already sprayed.
So we're going to pick that one up, which is right behind you.
Yeah, and so this one has dried for about 10 minutes.
Ooh, it already looks
so beautiful.
It doesn't
look really cool. So what we need to do, we need to put a backer on there, and I like to use a dark backer so that that mirror from the front will reflect even more, some more of that.
Shines through more.
Yeah,
okay.
So I take this the spray here. It's a, what is this?
Adhesive?
Adhesive, spray adhesive. And we're just going to spray it on the back here over what we sprayed already. Again, once it's dry, just cover that like this. I get this black poster board, and we're going
stick to the back.
Yeah, we're going to put it on here.
There you go. Line it up.
Yeah, I didn't line it up too well there, but
I mean,
anyway,
this is so creative.
We do this. We're going to flip it over, and we're going to cut the paper to fit.
Look at that.
But look how cool this is.
That is awesome.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Look how antique that looks. Just super cool.
People pay a lot of money for that.
Absolutely.
And you can do it at home,
the
DIY.
The reason I did this, I had a bookshelf, and I took the shelves out, and I wanted some mirror in there, but it was going to cost a couple $1,000s to get that look.
Right.
I had glass cut to fit. I sprayed it. I glued it up myself. It was like $200 all in all.
Savings as well. And listen, speaking of new, you have so many new things going on. We kind of mentioned about the new store that opened off of Montesano. You're doing so much more there as well.
Yes.
But then your new store is also going to be opening up this year.
Yes, footers and foundation and the slabbery and the steel's getting ready to go up. So I would think March or April we'll be in that brand new big store on Furious Ferry Road.
Well, listen, it's a new year and he's going to be with us throughout the year, every month, Trending with Signature Mike. So be sure to tune in every month to see what he has up his sleeve, like this awesome DIY.
Excited to be here. You never know.
I know. Mike, thank you so much for joining us.
Pleasure.
We really appreciate it. All right, guys, don't go anywhere. When we come back, we're revealing our new fashion expert. We'll be right back.